setting the right goals and starting fresh in 2018. Roll it. We talked about niching down. We talked about really focusing on some specific goals and really aligning ourselves to get moving in the right direction. In the first video, I talked about really looking at those goals we set in January. And through the months, how far have we gotten? Where are those little goals being achieved? And of course, where did our focus go? Why did we lose focus? And this really wraps it all into one little nice circular movement. Our first thing we want to look at is, where was our mindset at and what did we really want to achieve? Has that changed and by how much? Do we want to get back there? Then we have to look at our smaller goals and ask ourselves, are we going to make those small goals every single day so we can make that big goal? And lastly, how are we going to keep focus? What occurred to take away our focus? Starting fresh, we need to really settle on some awesome goals that we can really, really start to grow through the whole rest of this year. So when we say setting the right goals, it's what are the best goals that will see success for you, you specific, okay? It's not gonna be the same with everybody. It's specific to you and what you're trying to achieve. In the last video, I talked about niching down. I talked about looking at what the big goal was and how do we set smaller goals so that we can really niche into what we want to see success in so we can blossom out of that and start looking at those bigger goals over the latter part of this year. And then when we see that, we'll actually get moving in the right direction through to 2019. It's really crazy that I'm saying 2019 or 2018. It's just, it blows my mind that we're already in 2018. It's not depressing or anything, it just blows my mind. Time's flying. So let's look at this from the right perspective for you. Let's look at it from a perspective of what is the real big change you're trying to make. If it is a business, what are you trying to see in that business? What things do you really want to see new by the end of the year? If you really want to see something in your career change, what are the things you need to do to start moving in that right direction? What about your love life? What about your relationships? What about your health and your personal well-being? What are some things that you really want to see change? I was talking to somebody about their business the other day and they asked me, well, I tried to get online and I just haven't been able to. They wanted to do Facebook ads and they were just really not understanding how to do it. They tried and tried, they hired a couple people and it wasn't working out. The question then begs, well, what did you do and what did you not achieve that? And there you go, everything. Being specific really needs to help you address the situation. You know, I was talking to another person regarding their personal life and wanting to be better, more positive. Being specific at what they actually want to see is critical here to actually see that change. Being positive is hard. You can't just turn on the switch. It takes time. You can't just do Facebook ads. It takes time. Starting fresh, we actually have to look at it from a perspective of what can we actually achieve? What is it that we can actually do today to start moving in the right direction? If you're looking at being more positive, then we gotta actually address what is causing the negativity to arise. There's always a source of negativity. If you're trying to get your Facebook ads to get moving in the right direction, what have we tried? What do we need to focus on so that we can actually see that success? And we need to be able to start something today. So the first step is really addressing this inner me of, hey, I tried and I failed and I'm not able to do this or do that. It is actually looking at it from a perspective that says, hey, I had this big goal, it was totally out in left field. Now I'm gonna bring it back in. And when we look at that niching that we talked about, how can I start making small improvements so we can shape it up in the right direction? To start fresh means that we put everything away. We don't think about it. If you're looking to be better at relationships this year, It is to look at it from perspective that I'm gonna start reading up on how to have better relationships. I'm gonna start watching more videos. I'm gonna start getting focused in being better at relationships, and I'm gonna go practice on being the best I can be on it. And we gotta start fresh without being negative about it. We can't just sit there, and I know a lot of people go through this. Oh, relationships never work out for me. They don't work out for you because you haven't sat down to look at what you're doing wrong such that you don't repeat those mistakes and that you can actually have a successful relationship. Step two is actually looking at it and saying, now that I've analyzed it and I've gone through it and I've understood what I've done wrong and I've accepted it, now I'm gonna set these rules. I'm gonna do them for the next 120 days. And the challenge is that you're gonna do them for 120 days. Now this could be 30 days too, but if you do it for 120 days and you know that in between you'll stumble and you'll get back up and you, because you've committed to 120 days, it's a lot better than 30 days sometimes, because you might stumble more in those 30 days and then give up. But in the 120 days, you have that in your mindset that you're gonna be doing it for 120 days. So if I don't launch a video once or twice, you know what? I'm still hitting that 120 days. That's what I want. And I keep moving towards it. And those goals will be met, and you'll be more likely, I should say, to meet them if you stay focused on that round number of 120. Step three is really saying to yourself, I'm gonna be doing check-ins, and I'm gonna make sure I check in with myself to make sure, you notice I've been saying make sure so many times, that I'm being accountable. And I made a video on this, on how to do the check-in and how to be accountable for yourself so that you can get back on that horse, because that 120 days that we said we would do something needs to be met. And maybe you're not gonna achieve it right through to the 100% mark, but if you can get 50 or 60% and you can get halfway there, I guarantee you the next 3 months will be the starting point where you will redo a check-in in 120 days and then redo your goal settings for the latter part of this year. And all of a sudden by Christmas, you'll be hitting 80% of those 120 days. And this is how setting goals should occur. This is how starting fresh should occur. You should be making yourself accountable, accepting what's occurred, and then keep moving. And that's it. Keep starting, start over, but put it into a mindset that you're realizing what you're not achieving and what you should be achieving. This is Nico's RentThisMentorsApproach.com. Please comment below. Let me know the type of things that you're gonna do to achieve in the next 120 days. Let me know the kind of things that you're looking to see by the end of this year. And of course, click subscribe for more videos. I will be pumping out more as we go. I wanna see this community thrive, and I thank everybody who has been sending those messages and their emails and really communicating with me on the things that they're seeing and the things they want to see.